I'm at the gluten-free show, and how apropos to talk to Paul, who's going to talk about a gluten-free certification program, because you're with who again, Paul?
We represent the Canadian Celiac Association. Our company is the Allergen Control Group, and we're responsible for delivering and administering their gluten-free certification program.
Okay, so tell me about it. What should someone look at when they're trying to certify their product as gluten-free?
Sure, the gluten-free certification program was developed based on the Canadian regulations for gluten in manufacturing. And the program is designed to provide consumers with the added assurance that the products that they eat or shop for every day that are gluten-free are actually, in fact, safe for them to eat.
So how do you make it safe? What do you guys look at?
Right. Good.
Obviously, the facility, that is no cross-contamination, that's a given.
Yeah, well, it really does focus on the facility itself and a rigorous preventive approach to food safety in that manufacturing process. We do encourage testing as well of product, but we're not solely dependent on end product testing. We take a HACCP approach, which is a global food safety recognized standard approach, and that's done at the facility. So once the facility is recognized, then they get to use the gluten-free certification mark, which is an endorsement from the Canadian Celiac Association.
Okay, and anything else they should be aware of in terms of what you guys look for?
Yep, so that program, they're allowed to use the mark in their product packaging, in their marketing and so on, as long as they maintain that facility in a safe fashion. And in order to do that, they have to undergo an annual third-party audit by an approved and trained auditing company.
Okay. What are some of the common mistakes people make when they're trying to make their facility gluten-free? What are the things you really look at that just have to be there?
Well, in fact, most facilities are not dedicated gluten-free. That means they have flour or other contaminants, gluten contaminants in the facility. So their job is to manage that effectively so that there is no cross-contamination as they're manufacturing their product. That's the biggest challenge. The other challenge is that wheat-free does not mean necessarily gluten-free in Canada. And so therefore, we in Canada also do not allow oats in our product. So companies that are shipping product across the border into Canada, where there is no regulation in the U.S., have to be careful that their products are also oat-free in Canada.
So also then look at the supplier point of view, due diligence?
Yes, in fact, this program is heavily weighted on the supplier side and verifying and validating that their suppliers are also gluten-free, correct.
Let's talk about the verification program. How does it vary from country to country?
I'm sorry?
How does it vary country to country?
Yes, well, in Canada, gluten is regulated by Health Canada and enforced by the Canadian Food Inspection Agency. In the U.S., we don't have any regulation yet, but the globally accepted standard really is under 20 parts per million of gluten in the product. It's deemed safe for most celiacs and people with gluten sensitivity.
Okay. So, interesting stories you can tell us, and people trying to get their product certified, and how long is the process? And
sure. Very good question, actually. And depending on the organization and the facility, will depend on how long it takes them. Companies who already have good practices, good manufacturing practices in place, will actually could get through this process in a couple of months, I would think. But other organizations and facilities that have no manufacturing practices and preventive food safety programs in place could take them up to 6 months or a year to get ready for certification.
And what are the fees involved with something like this?
Sure. The fees are for the program are very inexpensive. There's a $499 application fee. It's a one-time fee. And then the company pays to use the endorsed mark by the CCA on an annual basis based on their annual gross sales and also based on the number of SKUs which they want to use the mark on.
Okay. Now, would you guys, inspect the facilities without invitation?
Okay.
Some other health food and other food inspectors, they just show up to. So
this is very much an announced audit. We don't audit them directly. We employ third-party auditing companies, so there's no conflict of interest whatsoever. And those third-party auditing companies would make an arrangement on a date that the facility feels that they're
something with the gluten-free mind website here behind us?
Absolutely, and we're very proud to be associated with Gluten-Free Fine. They are our consumer partner to help create more awareness about the gluten-free certification program and to alert consumers to look for the mark on products in their grocery shelves. GlutenFreeFine.com has been a tremendous partner to work with, and we're looking forward to a long-term relationship with them.
Great. Well, in terms of relating more to you and what you provide in terms of a gluten-free certification program, what's your website?
Yes, thank you. For those companies interested in learning more about the certification program, they can go to glutenfreecertification.ca, and on there, there's all kinds of resources, Q&As and fee structures and so on, and they can learn, you know, take some right through the process. And on behalf of the Canadian Celiac Association, who are behind this program, I think the biggest thing to note is that they are endorsing the product that gets certified. Their name is on your product, and I think that really differentiates your product in the marketplace.
Great. Well, thank you so much for your time, Bob. It's been very informative.
Thank you very much.